Lazzato here in northern Italy. We are getting ourselves ready for our last day of finals when it comes to shotgun, but of course we've got the skeet competitions coming up later in the week. It is the time for the trap mixed team competition. Remember, it debuted, didn't it, in Tokyo at the Olympic Games, and was a great success as well. We've got a lot of very successful Olympians lined up in this afternoon's competition. The weather has decided to become benign. It poured with rain last night, absolutely poured with rain. Some of the locals are still wrapped up warm, but I guess they're used to, someone said to me, one of our Italian hosts said, we were used to 28 degrees. This is not what we would call warm weather. I'm in shirt sleeves. As are some of our officials as well. Two bronze medal matches, two bronze medals to give, and then our gold and medal match coming up. So this is a lot of fun. I think it's still very important, but perhaps the pressure's off after the individual events, and it'll be interesting to see some really established athletes alongside one of our athletes is just 15 years of age. So it will be interesting to see how it all pans out. Shotguns vary in design, but those are the fundamentals. You can spend an awful lot of money if you want to. And if you're interested in taking up the sport, go to your local club and I'm sure you'll be able to get a feel for it without making the outlay first. They love their sport shooting here in northern Italy, run by Lake Garda. We are absolutely beautiful part of the country. It's poppy season as well, early in the poppy season, but there are fields that are dappled red in the sunshine. It is absolutely beautiful, and it's always a pleasure to come here and be welcomed by our hosts. Or nothing less than completely welcoming. Sun has dipped behind the clouds. The wind is just a little bit breezy, nothing terrible from right to left. Our first medal match, well, it's the locals. It's Italy against Slovakia. Gazzini against, and Etzi against Drobny and Rehak Stefasikova of Slovakia. Oh, here's Clayton. I was speaking to the genius behind the scenes of the Ascot this morning. Much happier with the weather than when it's 28 degrees and almost passing out in the heat. Waiting for the athletes to be introduced to us. Sunday afternoon, what better time to settle down and watch some top-notch shotgun action. Clayton, not a competitor, but always welcome, always welcome. So we have two bronze medal matches. Our first bronze medal match is between Slovakia and Italy. Then we will see Australia against the Czech Republic. But the warmest welcome, I am sure, for these two, Alessia Ajetzi and Valerio Grazzini. And of course, Alberto Pero. Signor Pera. Olympic medalist in his own right, of course, back in the day. And he will be the man once again on duty in the coach's chair. Up against a really decent Slovakian team, Edwin Drobny, and of course, Susanna Rehak Stefasikova. the reigning Olympic champion, individual Olympic champion. What a day that was in Tokyo. Yes. Fast becoming almost a year ago, isn't it? How time flies, and we're about to get underway in our next set of quotas towards Paris, but let's not worry about that just yet. Let's worry about this competition. I do remember in charge is from Italy, Daniel Gelfi. Fist pumps all around. He's the man who will be brought in should there be any issues needing resolving. Our referee is from France. He said bonjour to Christophe Busch. And just to say, our VAR official is Piotr Hrdobla of Germany, tucked away in the corner by the screen, just in case a VAR card goes up. The officials, the coaches rather, and the athletes can question any of the decisions should they want, just to make sure, and we will check on the video screens. It seems only fair. In the 21st century, all sports seem to be doing it. So this is a match between Italy and between Slovakia. Slovakia qualifying third. Italy, goodness me, what was it, a five-way shoot-off to be the last team to make it. And a reminder of how this works, it's a first to 6 points format, so we have five series of five targets. You can see them set out on the screens there. 10 points per team per series. Whoever gets the most hits will get 2 points. If it's level after those 10 targets per team, five targets per athlete, then we will have a point apiece. If we get to five series and it is equal, then we go to sudden death shoot-off. First miss from Drobny, the 26-year-old. Here's the Olympic champion, Rek Stefanskova. Yadzi.
Ah.
25-year-old, the junior world champion. And also has a World Cup final gold as well. So what another prospect for the next, goodness knows how long for Italy. Alongside Grazzini, very impressive. Drobny, another youngster, just 26 years of age. Got a mixed team silver in New Delhi last year. So he's well used to this competition, although it is a slightly different format. So Drobny struggling a wee bit. No one else missing as of yet. Let's see. And there's our first Italian miss. So far, it's still advantage to Italy. Drobny needs to get his form back here. Team gold at the European Championships last year. So very much enjoys this team in mixed team format. Well, you can just see the class in Rek Stefanskova. No nonsense, goes about her business. Way to the right, that was a tricky one. And that was a miss. And straight away, Alberto Pera puts up the VAR card. And we will have a little trot over to the VAR booth. So the three officials will review this just to see if there was any variation. I'm not the referee and I'm not as close to the action as he was, but I couldn't see anything on that. And yeah, well, these athletes and coaches get two reviews per match, and I can't see any deviation, but we'll see what our referee says. Certainly got that centre of frame for our three wise men and ladies, or lady to work out. Here we go. Let's see what the signal is from the referee. Yeah, it's a thumbs down. We haven't seen too many successful reviews throughout the last 3 days. And so it's a couple of misses per team at the moment, but still a time for that to change. Shot echoing around from the skeet athletes practicing ahead of their turn on the centre stage. That's Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, our finals. Hope you can join us for that. So six apiece. Are we going to be sharing the points here? Better from Drobny. He has recovered from that little wobble. Be interesting to see what Ietsi can do. So at least a point. Donajic, the Slovakian coach. Oh, now then, that looked like a miss, and yes, anything flying near that target was the casing of the cartridge.
Oh.
And so that miss was important, very important indeed. And Slovakia managed to get the 2 points, 8-7 in that first series. And a timeout has been called. Albano Pera marching over to have a quick word with the 29-year-old. World Cup gold winner in Acapulco. And Alessi, the 25-year-old, well, she has a real pedigree as well. Junior world champion, World Cup final gold. And you may remember she qualified second in the individual qualification, but she was ranking points only. So three athletes named by Italy that could go forward to the finals. And she wasn't one of them. She was one of the other two that were in there just really for practice and ranking points. But she really made everyone sit up and take notice. So we know that she's got the temperament, she's got the talent. Just sometimes there's a bump on the road or two. And Italy with a bit of work to do. Remember, two bronze medals being given out in these two bronze medal matches. Good start from Italy, good start from Drobny. Rejek Stefasikova, well. Is away to the right. I was about to say you can bet your bottom dollars she'll hit her target, but well, that's the nature of the sport. That was a brute of a target coming out quite high into the right. And sometimes even the best, even the Olympic champion, can miss. First to six, remember, for one of these two bronze medals on offer. Our second bronze medal match is coming up. Australia against the Czech Republic. Low, better angle, no problem this time for the 38-year-old. Only made the relay, the semi-final, so to speak, in the medal matches. I'm quite surprised at that as well, but form is temporary, class is permanent, as they say. I'm sure she will add to a massive haul of medals. Number one, 17 golds, 13 silvers, 13 bronzes, missed by Drobny. This is going much better for the Italians this time. Perhaps a good word in the ear from Albano Pera. A man who's been to a couple of Olympic Games himself and has a silver medal. If memory serves, it was double trap.
Oh. Oh.
Well, 6. V8. A point is the best that the Slovakians can hope for.
Ah.
Well, the Italians need Grazzini to get over the line here.
Oh.
Oh, and a miss. Well, well, well. A twist in this series. Well, dropping in, Rajek Sefisakova.
Oh.
Looked as if they were going to get nothing out of this series, but they might get a point.
Oh.
Oh, and that's a miss. And the VAR card goes up straight away from the Slovakian coach. And more in hope than expectation, I'd say. Couldn't see anything. But you never know. Yeah, an official review, this time for Slovakia. At the moment, the scoreboard says 2-2. But we will see whether that last red is to overturn to green. Waiting for the officials to see. We are waiting as you are waiting. We will let you know as soon as we know. Athletes, meantime, in their positions, head down in the zone. We always say, perhaps too often, but I'm sure you'll excuse us for saying that it's as much a mental game as a physical. I mean, it is physical. Long hours of qualification, long hours of hanging around as well. But once you're on the shooting position, then you really do need to focus. Well, they're still looking. They're still thinking about it. We are not seeing what they are seeing. And I, for once, can't see over their shoulder. So I can't bring you any extra news. A little shake of the head. I think we know which way this thumb's going to go. There you go. And so, an uncharacteristic mistake. It was a difficult one, high to the left, but a miss. And that unexpected chance to get a point has vanished for Slovakia. And we are at 2 apiece after 2 series.
Oh.
Third series then. Evenly poised in this first of our 2 bronze medal matches. Oh. Down the line, no worries at all this time for Zuzana Rajek-Sefisakova, veteran. Seen it all before. Doesn't mean you can't miss from time to time. Let's see. Not making a mistake. Oh. What about her compatriot? No problems at all. Fairly benign angle for her, for him rather. Now Drobny. And from Tanava, would rank 26. And, well, this is would rank number 1 athlete, and she's having a shocker at the moment. And we saw this in the relay, in the individual as well. I guess it's better to have your wobbles in a World Cup early in the season than at a World Championships or a Olympic Games. But even so, she'll be disappointed. Just the one miss then. Close. Will Italy come from behind to take the lead? Well, no, very soon.
Oh.
Just gone now, 4 o'clock local time. The lengthening shadows. Not too bad at the moment. The light is perfect. Yesterday was pretty dank and dark and grey and Those light enhancing glasses are very important. Not so much today. They'll still wear them, of course, and you'd perhaps change the lenses to a lighter one. See what they prefer. Slightly darker. Drobny. He's done his part. He's shooting really well. Let's see how Ray Extaf has to come about.
Oh.
That's another one. That's a shocker. Nasty to the left, but she, for some reason, is not firing on all cylinders at the moment.
Ah.
Down the middle. That's a nice one to get and remember. They get a prescribed number to the left, to the right, and straight down the middle.
Oh.
Couple to the left, couple to the right. And if you're counting the targets, well, then you start to work out what's coming next. There still is mere mortal to be happy just to hit the target. Slightly more complex, and that is another miss. This time, low and to the left. 3 out of 5. And these two shots, academic really. But it'll be nice to have a 10 out of 10. I'm sure the Italian coach will tell them.
Oh.
And it is 10 out of 10. Drobny doing his bit. Stefa Sokova struggling. And it's not very often you say that. And Italy take the lead. 4 points to 2 in the race to 6 to take one of the bronze medals on offer here at Lenato this afternoon. Here we go again then. This, our fourth series. Can Slovakia take it to a decider? Well, otherwise, I guess we'll be on Rejak Stefčakova. Good again from Italy, putting the pressure on Slovakia. Oh, that was brutally high. It really was flying, that one. Remember, there are random tables. One is chosen at random, programmed in, and you get what you get. But that was not nice. You've got to be able to deal with all of them, and it will be the same for everybody over the course of the competition. Let's see with a miss. Glazzini. Looking to keep the advantage. And Robbins was solid in the last series. Missed another one. Not so solid in this one. You can just see a little slump in the shoulders as he took that one in.
Oh.
Well, this time it's Rejak Stefčakova who is hauling the Slovakians closer to the Italians, but they're still one behind. Hand goes up from the athlete straight away. She was absolutely convinced that was a hit. So, back to the screens we go. This is what they're looking at just on my left-hand side. Is there a puff of powder or something coming off there, or a change in the rotation pattern of that target? It's not going to be hit from there, is it? So we just need to, that's it, go the other way. I think sometimes it's instructive to see it in real time as well, before it's slowed back down again. Our super slow-mo cameras. It's, no thank you. The locals don't like it, but our referee certainly agreed with his other officials. So, double miss for the Italian woman, the 25-year-old, having a bit of a torrid time alongside Drobny. Glazini has had to wait a while. Will his concentration still be intact?
Oh.
Yes, tricky one to the right, not a problem at all.
Oh.
Well, for the left-hander, that was a slightly more difficult target. Did it well and gets himself in the green at last in this series. Stefasikova, Rehak Stefasikova, back in it again. Did well. Let's see.
Oh.
And they're back on it. Glazini has been very good in this series. Rehak Stefasikova also is back on form, but Drobny all of a sudden isn't. So let's see what happens here.
Oh,
ooh, it's a low one and it's a miss. It's a miss. So, two more targets per team and we will see whether Italy are over the line. They have the advantage. Just need this one.
Oh.
Ooh, no, no. Little look from the referee left and right to his assistants who are also watching, and they agree that was red as well. So a chance to stay in here and take a point. Well, how important will that miss be by Grazini? Well, they can't get over the line in this series. It is a point apiece. Drama here in Lenato, and Slovakia stay in it. They still trail though, 5-3. Chance for a quick sip of the water, straight back on it though. Here he is, wrapped up warm. I don't think it's hot weather. I've got to be honest with you, Dad doesn't think so. He's probably got a bit more to keep warm than his son. Not quite sun cream on the head weather either, though, if truth be told.
Oh.
Well, not a good start from Slovakia, and they need to do well here. Remember, they need to win here. A point will do it for Italy. Good start for me, let's see.
Oh.
Not a good start from Grazini. Oh, Balan Owen would know what to do.
Oh.
Into his 70s now, still coaching. Still a charismatic presence in the coach's chair.
Oh.
That's another miss from the Olympic champion. Goodness me. Good from the young Italian. Let's see. Glazini also backing her up. Drobny and Stefasikova both struggling a wee bit at the moment. They need Italy to falter if they want to stay in this bronze medal match. Nicely tracked, nicely dispatched.
Oh.
Nice and easy on the angle, that one. Getting towards crunch time here. Oh. It is Slovakia on the back foot. Now then, let's keep an eye on this. Form of Rex Tefasakova. Oh. Certainly in the individual relay wasn't great. It hasn't been brilliant here. And they are. Well, we'll see what happens in the next two shots. They are technically behind. Not now. Always good to wait, isn't it? Yeah, let's see with the miss. Remember, a tie is good enough to get to 6 points, a point apiece. Oh. It'll take the bronze medal.
Oh.
Way to the left, not a problem. Well,
oh.
This is an important one. There we go. But it's not going to be enough. A point will be enough for the Italians.
Ah.
And that's a miss. Well, well, well. You can barely look.
Oh.
8-7, it's 5 apiece. And despite the problems of Drobny and Rajak Tefasakova in particular, they have brought it back from 4-2 down, it's 5 apiece. And we go now to a sudden death shoot-off. Susanna Rajak Tefasakova just nipping off to get some extra cartridges. We did have a shoot-off, I think it was yesterday, wasn't it? Only lasted one round. Wrapped up warm, tucked up in the best seat in the house. Better than all the comfy seats. Public holiday here tomorrow, so he's got an extra day off. Do remember, just clarifying how this will work, but of course it will be Slovakia, as I understand it, who will shoot first. They had the highest qualification, although I will never take that as gospel until we see it at the shooting position. And then obviously an Italian athlete will shoot, and we will alternate until somebody blinks. So it will be Drobny, followed by Etsy. Let's see how long this one takes to sort out. This for the bronze medal. We're into the shoot-off.
Oh.
And most athletes will tell you, they prefer to go first, put the pressure on the athlete going second. But athletes really shouldn't worry about the holistic situation, just that one shot that they have to take.
Ah.
Oh dear, there you go, missed straight away. Well, like the previous shoot-off we had yesterday, it's over pretty quickly, and it is Slovakia who came back from 4-2 down to get to 5-5. They rode their luck, really did. No wonder they're celebrating. And they take the first of the two bronze medals on offer here in Lenato. Congratulations to Adrian Drobny, Susanna Rajak Tefasakova, and well, never mind, another day perhaps for the Italians, the home crowd, nothing to cheer. And well, it was exciting for the neutral. And that's the first bronze medal match. Second one underway in just a few minutes' time. Don't go anywhere.
aspetta. Argini in onda, totale.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here we are with the team for bronze medal match event 2. On position number 5, representing team of Czech Republic.
Well, here we go then. Second bronze medal match, another chance to get a bronze medal. It'll be crowded on the podium, won't it? James Willett, Catherine Skinner, Jiří Liptak, Lea Kucherova of the Czech Republic. Just 15 years and 9 months. Lea already had some silverware in her cabinet. We'll go through that later on. And of course, well, Liptak, 40 years of age and the Olympic champion. Shows what a quality field we have after Reha Ksefasakova. Well, you can hear the Australians are in the stands cheering on their teammates. And they've come a long way and are really pleased to be back out of quarantine and competing. They're here for, in Europe for 7 weeks and then the sweep down to Baku will be their last, and then they head off home again. And they've had a pretty successful time here in Lonato. Daniela Gelfi is our jury member in charge. And a French referee is back on the range as well. Christophe Busch and Pieter Heidobler. It's worth a mention, of course, one of our officials who is sitting in the VAR booth helping to officiate. So, Australia against Czech Republic. We've already seen Slovakia take the other bronze. There was a bit of a conversation, shall we say, between Albert and Perra and the officials about the targets, because obviously it is known before and how many go left, how many go right. Now we go straight on. Normally, a couple to the left, a couple to the right, one down the middle.
Ho!
For each athlete. And they weren't entirely sure whether they just wanted confirmation on that.
Oh.
But we are quickly underway in this bronze medal match. May explain why there were so many misses in that first competition, but anyway, it was the same for both teams. It's a level playing field, and this is a level score at the moment. Here's the farmer from Mulwala in New South Wales, watched on by Richard Salmon. Mulwala. You couldn't get a more Australian sounding name, could you? World rank number 13 is Willett. Liptak, as we mentioned, reigning Olympic champion. Kucherova, 15 years, goodness me, of age. Likes Osijek, funnily enough. Team bronze in 2021, junior European Championship bronze last year as well. Here's Skinner, got the team gold yesterday, looking for the bronze medal here. Qualified in fourth.
Oh.
Four shots, four targets off of getting into the gold medal match. By the way, in case you hadn't checked, there's no reason why you should do, sorry, I'll tell you, the gold medal match is an all-Spanish affair. Spain 1 versus Spain 2. That coming up after this. Just one miss at the moment. James Willett.
Ho!
Skinner, no nonsense. You can hear her call of Paul. Nice from the Czech pair. Veteran and novice.
Whoa!
Working in tandem. Just the one miss so far. Really good start to this second bronze medal match.
Ho!
Ah. Oh.
Ooh, a miss and straight away. No, 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 no. Was the call. From Liptak. go to the screens. He was instantly convinced once that hand went up. No, 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 the man from Bruno said. Let's see. Oh, there, might, was there something there? Possibly not, might be something in the background. We'll have a look, it's around here. Can you see anything? If you were the official in the gilet, would you be giving that a thumbs up or a thumbs down? I can't see anything that would change the decision. We still wait. They're still looking. 40 years of age now and looking as good as an athlete as he always has. Well, they're having a good look, aren't they? Three pairs of glasses focused on on the screen. He's got a wry smile. He's not going to be happy if they don't give it, but we will see. They've, I think, come to a decision. It wasn't the easiest one to make for the officials. Monsieur Bush gives it a thumbs up. Yeah, he must have seen something. It was a very difficult decision to make for those officials. And we're underway again. Well, important, wasn't it? Because guarantees at least a point. Oh, and it is just going to be a point. And the card goes up again. You can have two of these. So he's played all his chips in this opening series. At the moment, it's a point apiece. Better. Heruska. Well, hit or miss, they have to get ready for the next series. Was there a little movement there? These are moving at 120 kilometres an hour. And our cameramen are good, but just sometimes it disappears out of frame. And they're asking for it to be rewound a bit more. I think the interest is around here somewhere. Right, let's have a look at it from here. Well, they want to see it really slow. I think there might have been a wobble. It's not the easiest two reviews you will see. Well, they're still looking. Smile from the youngster. Did well last year, despite all the pandemic restrictions in Osijek. Very extensive range there. And again, very good hosts. We enjoyed ourselves there. That's a no then this time. So it is an important decision because it means that it is a point apiece after the first series. Second series, here we go. Czech Republic will get us underway first of all. And a miss, first of all. Not challenged, in fact, it can't be challenged. They've had two challenges already. It's a tricky old decision, isn't it, as a coach? Do you decide to go early? Oh, and that's a miss. Flies away into the distance. Just going to not need to watch it disappear. She's already getting ready for the next one.
Whoa. Ho.
Oh, that's a second miss. She's looking at that one as it disappears. Australians are struggling here at the moment. Kucherova is belying a tender age here and shooting very, very well indeed. What a prospect she is. And you can stay in the junior ranks till you're 21. She doesn't need to, does she, really? Three in a row. Can't quite believe what she's seeing. And this is going to be surely 2 points for the Czech Republic.
Whoa! Ho!
They just shot well. What is going on with Skinner? She is such an accomplished athlete. Gold yesterday in the team. It's just not clicking for her at the moment. Will there be a timeout anytime soon? I mean, this is gone, hasn't it? But I guess that's not really the point.
Whoa!
Well, this will be interesting. It doesn't matter, but it will matter to her. Down the middle, that'll help. Well, 2 points to the Czech Republic, just missing the one target. Catherine Skinner will feel the weight of responsibility on her shoulders, having had a bit of a shocker of a series. Richard Salmon not calling a timeout. I think we'll just see how it goes in this series. May need to if there's continuing problems. Way to the left, not a problem for the 26-year-old. Here is Skinner.
Ho!
Oh.
More laconic pool sander from Liptak. And isn't Kucherova shooting so well at the moment?
Whoa.
This time it's Willett who's in the red. Skinner needs to find some form.
Whoa.
That's better. Still looks dissatisfied, doesn't she? Maybe it's the way she approaches her shooting. And that's an aid to the Australians. A miss from Liptak on the collector's item. Started off in a really high quality first series, not so much in the second series, and a couple of misses already in this third series.
Ho!
Oh, she's back on it, isn't she? Certainly is now.
Oh.
Finally balanced. That's two targets for each of these athletes now.
Whoa!
Down the middle, just a little puff of the pink powder. He got enough of it.
Ho!
Oh, and that one wide and to the right, and it's a miss. Now then, Liptak and Kucherova have a chance to edge in front. Nope, not this time. Got some tricky targets for these athletes to tackle. The light, the clouds are massing away to my left. At the moment, it's still pretty light, pretty mild. Don't think we can blame the weather this time. So Skinner, sometimes you just have those days where you're unable to get the consistency. That's a lot better. She'd be happy enough with that, I'm sure. after the horror show of the last series. Ooh. And a miss right at the end, so no points for the Czech Republic this time. It is seesawing at the moment, 3 points apiece after three series. Salmon with the VAR card in his hand, he still has a couple of those up his sleeve. There's also, of course, a timeout to be had should they want it. Series number four. Good start from the Czech pair.
Whoa.
Well, by now they will be starting to work out from each station where these targets are going. Kucherova has been excellent. More than half the age of her teammate.
Ho!
5 years younger. But they're working well together. And it is the senior, the 40-year-old Liptak, who has the first red of this series. Oh dear, commentator's curse.
Whoa!
Well, Australia with a chance to take it to within a point of the bronze medal.
Oh.
Whoa.
Sitting pretty at the moment, the Australians. Skinner back into her more normal form, which is lots of greens. So two hits here needed to have any chance of a point. You never know, stranger things have happened. Kucherova, not a problem, difficult target, made it look easy. But just one out of two needed to make it 5-3. Doing 3-1 down, there you go. What a comeback that has been.
Oh.
10 out of 10. A convincing win in that series, the fourth series. We go to a fifth series. Czech Republic have to win this one to take it to a shoot-off. A tie or a win for Australia will give that second bronze medal to Australia. Here we go then.
Whoa!
Gold medal match still to come. Our eyes very much focused on this bronze medal battle between Australia and the Czech Republic. Oh, another one from Skinner.
Oh,
she had such a good day yesterday. Isn't it weird how things can swing around and she still might get the bronze medal? Both these bronze medal matches almost been a case of the teams being reluctant to get over the line. The last one between Italy and Slovakia certainly went to a shoot-off, and it went because shots weren't taken when, to use a football parlance, the goal was open for tapping from 2 yards. And this might well go to a shoot-off. May have spoken too soon.
Whoa.
That's another one. Ooh, it's all getting a bit, well, I would say nervy, but I'm not sure these athletes have too many nerves.
Ho!
Wave. Had a shallow angle to the left, never a problem for Skinner. So at the moment, it's advantage, advantage, Czech Republic once again. The next shot proves me wrong. Four apiece. That'll suit Australia if it stays tied.
Ho!
Better.
Oh.
They know now, they just have to worry about their own targets and the rest will look after itself. Must be getting near the gold medal match. Adam Galvez is just taking off a warm coat, ready to take to the arena soon, but we've still got some business to attend to here. This important target, and it is a miss. And we are going to stop because they cannot be overhauled, and so the points will go to Australia. Well, there's just a conflab to my left about this. No, no, we carry on. It doesn't matter. They will be still in the zone.
Whoa.
Now they're making sure. There's the round of applause. Skinner tidies up nicely as well. Two more targets to go. It is going to be a 7-3 win for Australia. Nicely done from Kucherova, who has been very impressive. But it's not going to be enough. And after being 3-1 down, it is Australia who take the bronze by 7-3. Congratulations from the coach Salmon. Commiserations from coach Horutska. Fourth place goes to Liptap and Kucherova. They can still smile. And the Australians, well, they join Slovakia on the bottom step of the podium a little bit later on. Now we will decide very soon who takes the gold medal. We know it's going to be Spain, but it's which of the two Spanish teams that are in the gold medal match. That is coming up next. Thank you.
Division number 2, representing Spain 2, let's welcome the team of Adria Martinez Torres and Marco Lima Camino, and the coach, Mr. Marcello Dadim. Today's results, 139 targets. First time competing together. And today should cross Martinez Torres.
Here we go then, gold medal match. One thing I can tell you, Spain are going to take gold and Spain will take silver. It's Spain 1 against Spain 2. What an embarrassment of riches they have. Alberto Fernandez, Fatima Galvez, Spain 1. And Spain 2, a team of Adria Martinez Torres and Marmone Magrina. Two coaches who will be very comfortable in each other's company as well. Jorge Arias for Spain 1, Marcello Dradi for Spain 2.
And referee so, in charge.
Very, very nice position for the Spaniards to be in. Our coach, our jury member, is from Italy, Daniele Gelfi. And our referee is still our Frenchman, Christophe Bouche. Okay. It's getting a bit cooler around here. As you can see, the flags not really straining on their strings. It's just gone 5 local time and the gold medal match. Just a little later than we were anticipating because of the shoot-offs in the bronze medal matches. If you just joined us, bronze to Australia, and the other bronze medal match, Slovakia as well. Fernandez gets us underway with a green. Reminder of how it works, it's first to 6 points, and in each series of 5 targets for each athlete, well, the highest combined total will get the victorious team 2 points. And Galvez with our first red. You wouldn't really expect that, would you? Got the team bronze yesterday, of course. Guaranteed at least one better.
Oh.
He's had a very successful career. There's many teams with the Spanish team at the moment. Marcello Dardi. The 23-year-old Andrea Martinez Torres. Two World Cup junior golds for him. Even younger, Marmone Magrina. Just 20 years of age. A junior European champion here in Lonato back in 2019. Fernandez, as we expect from the world number one, starting well. The man from Madrid, 38 years of age, and of course, gold medalist in Tokyo in the mixed team competition. So he likes this format.
Oh dear,
Galvez with 2 misses and a miss now for Mone Magrina. Arias, watching on, in charge of Fernandez and Galvez. Interesting, isn't it? Alberto Fernandez, Galvez with that mixed team gold in Tokyo. But the youngsters, Martinez Torres, Morgan, Magrina, will be eyeing up a chance to do the mixed team competition in Paris, I am sure. All depends on getting a quota place first of all, and then proving to the selectors and the coaches that you are worth that place on the starting qualification lineup. Only 2 years away now, of course. Chance to take the first 2 points. Ooh, the hand goes up. And it's a point apiece. Eight apiece. Two misses that last one right at the end of the series. A disappointment for Monet Magrina, I am sure. This time it is Spain 2 that will get us underway.
Four.
And they get us underway very nicely indeed.
Four.
Oh, way low to the right. Not nice for Galvez. 13 gold medals in her career. World champion here in Linato 7 years ago now. World Cup gold in Lima.
Oh.
They need to keep it in the green and hope their compatriots stumble at some stage. Very relaxed, Galvez, before this competition. I suppose you would be, wouldn't you, if you know you're guaranteed at least a silver. No, there's not that awful fourth place. That's not a possibility. Some of the formats, there's four in the final, and you know somebody's not going to make it to the podium.
Oh.
Well, that was the case, of course, in the bronze medal matches, but they qualify very well. Galvez and Fernandez, 140 out of 150, and Monet Magrina, Martinez Torres, 139. A couple of points ahead of Slovakia. Galvez. Saying that, Rex Stefasikova, really experienced athletes, just struggling a little bit.
Oh,
remember, maximum of five series we can have.
Oh,
and then it goes to a shoot off, like we saw in one of the bronze medal matches, only lasted one target per team.
Oh.
Down the middle. You'll get one of those from each station. A couple to the left, a couple to the right.
Oh.
Of course. And goes up, there's a miss. You're never quite sure when. Unless you are counting the targets, then you start to get an idea. And remember, the left can be just slightly to the left, or it can be 45 degrees. It can be very high, it can be pretty low. That's a pretty high one. And you see that shot, a very good example of just how fast the targets fly out of the trap. Well, another eight apiece, another point apiece. And will it be five apiece in the shoot off? Someone's called a timeout. Marcello Tardi wanted to talk briefly. Ramone Magrina is the recipient of that advice. Sunshine here in Linato. Wonderful finals arena.
Four.
Well, oh.
Oh, there is a miss. Morning, Magrina. First one to hit the red in this gold medal match series number three. Point apiece in each of the first two series. It's tight between these two. Both eight points apiece. So the one we have seen in the bronze medal matches are 15 v 15. Not quite that level at the moment.
Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Oh.
Down the middle, high, not a problem. Six out of six at the moment for Fernandez and Galvez. Martinez, Torres and Molina Magrina are at a disadvantage here at the moment. Oh, even more of a disadvantage. No, she got a bit of that target. Looked over her shoulder at the referee, whose hand stayed by his sides.
Oh.
They haven't this time. That's a miss for Fernandez. And again, one miss apiece from these two teams. Another one. Goodness me. They have the chance to draw level after these two targets. They are one behind. Let's see if Fernandez and Galvez can get over the line this time. And this would ensure 2 points. Whatever happens now, they're going to come up a bit short. Martinez, Torres and Molne Magrina.
Oh.
But you will always want to finish with a hit. And they have as well, but not enough. This time just the one miss from Fernandez and Galvez. And they take the 2 points. They lead by 4 points to two in the race to six. And remember, if they take the next one, then they take the gold medal. Relaxed coaches, both the Spaniards enjoying their work. They will be happy to see a gold and silver haul, as I'm sure will their bosses. We often talk about the Italians, the Americans, but in shotgun, the Spaniards certainly hold their own. And Molina Magrina showing how disappointed she was there with that miss.
She's
20 years of age. We had a 15-year-old earlier in the bronze medal matches, Lia Kucherova of the Czech Republic. A lot of talent coming through, has to be said. Well, everyone's missing now. Is it going to be a scramble to the line? There, but they have to keep hitting Fernandez and Galvez. And you got the team silver in the World Cup in Lima just a week or so ago. Martinez Torres, he'll be hoping for better here, but it might be another silver. 23-year-old, the world ranked number six. Galvez didn't have a very good first series. It's looking a lot better here.
Oh.
Fernandez trying to steer him and Galvez to the gold medal. Oh, not the time to miss. That's never a good time, is there? But goodness me. Only need to keep calm and carry on, as they say. Well, Moni Magrina will really want to hit this one, and she does. So then, two greens, and the gold is there. There's the first one. All down to Galvez. And she does it as well, and they get over the line. The experienced pair, the Olympic champions in mixed team, take a gold here in Lonato at the World Cup. But certainly we've seen what the youngsters from Spain can do. Martinez Torres, Moni Magrina, they will take the silver, but those are the pair who take the gold, Fernandez and Galvez. The experienced pairing, smiles all round. Spain generally the winner. They take the top two steps of the podium. And remember, there are two bronze medals going to the Australians, James Willard, Catherine Skinner, and also to Slovakia, Adrian Drobny and Susanna Rehak Stefasikova. The last action of the trap part of this World Cup. Remember, it's keep coming up Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We'll be looking forward to having your company. Congratulations all round. The athletes able to relax now. Competition done and dusted. It's a bit like wrestling eels at this point. They try, the jury members, to get the teams in the right order and all together. Getting the coaches out of the way. I think we've just about got them lined up. And there is confirmation of those athletes that will be on the podium very shortly in the arena just behind us. Australia, Slovakia take the bronze, but it is a triumph for Spain, who take the gold and the silver.
Finally together, now I need to bend the light with color. We'll rise again, now I know we will be here. Rise our hands for love.